Next speaker is Arthur Stockwell. Good evening.
Dear Mayor and City Commissioners, thank you for hearing this non-agenda item. My name is Arthur Stockwell. I'm an active volunteer in a number of local charities and nonprofits that support our low-income residents, and I work for a downtown business. There is an issue I'm becoming very concerned about. It's a potential for a divisive confrontation between groups who want to end the St. Francis meal limit and groups that believe that will increase the population of homeless individuals congregating downtown. I think a vote on this topic of the increasing the meal limit before looking at solutions that worked in other communities who came to win-win solutions would set the stage for a confrontation between supporters of ending the meal limit and downtown businesses and the residential community. I think that conflict would end in a stalemate with both sides more bitter and upset than they already are. I'm from Austin, Texas, and we had a similar issue, but the numbers were on a much larger scale. We solved it with intelligent and fair zoning laws that helped Sixth Street flourish into what it is today, and care and recovery systems for the homeless that help many become unhomeless. My end in mind is to take and propose plans and actions that will divert a divisive conflict that is forming and to put us on a course towards a win-win solution for all. I have an idea that still needs a lot of work that is based on my work in Austin and the St. Petersburg Free Clinic, which I was a member of the board of directors for before moving to Gainesville, and that I think all sides could accept as a win-win solution. Its details are well beyond the time limit I'm running up on. I've spoken to members of the Coalition to End Meal Limits Now, and they asked if I'd be willing to come talk to them at their next meeting. I've spoken to members of the downtown business community, and they would like to talk as well. I'm also aware of a meeting Debbie Mason, who's with the United Way, called to open a dialogue on these issues, which I understand she was asked to do by one of you. Thank you for doing so. I was told at the screening of Civil Indigent this weekend that the vote on raising the meal limit at the St. Francis House was going to be on May 5th. If that's correct, please postpone it. Instead, please commission or lead the local community into putting a bipartisan group together to look at all the issues, what other communities have done to address similar issues in their communities, and charter them to develop and propose a win-win plan for all of us. Again, thank you for your time and attention and for what you do for our community.
Thank you, Mr. Stockwell. And I guess a little bit of a notification that actually we've discussed when the meeting might occur where that will be brought up, and actually it's looking like it will be June at the earliest and not at either regular meeting in May.
That's great. Thank you.
Thank you, and thanks for your interest in this issue. And actually, I look forward to learning more about what Austin has done and other communities as well. If you don't mind, I'll be in contact with you. Thank you.
We'll be happy to travel to Austin.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Joe Sinker. I'm with the Coalition to End the Meal Limit Now. I'd like to speak to the vague comments made by Art Stockwell, who is a CFO for Paradigm Companies, owned by Nathan Collier. The plan that he put before us at the Coalition is to essentially privatize the Beau Diddley Plaza and to make it so that no people who are not either buying, selling, or eating can congregate in the Beau Diddley Plaza as a way to push the homeless out of the downtown area of Gainesville. This is something that we told him at that meeting would be unacceptable to us and unacceptable to a gross majority of the population of Gainesville as well. Such a thing would essentially criminalize homelessness. He is going to present it to you in a way where he'll say that it's equitable, that it's not going to just focus on homeless or target homeless people. But who can say who's homeless and who's not? At our meeting, he mentioned maybe people could be forced to bring identification cards with them to prove whether they're homeless or whether they have a shelter to live at. Will it be based on the color of somebody's skin? Will it be based on whether they're in a business suit or not? Such a thing is not just, especially for an area that is a community plaza and is not a private property. We want to know if it's going to be equitably enforced, how will that happen? How is it going to be proven that somebody is not passing through, eating, or just hanging out. And we're going to be there with video cameras to record who's pushed out and who isn't, just so that we can prove, is this really equitable or not? Is it something that people who are coming out of the courthouse, you know, can they sit on a park bench? I mean, it's a ridiculous plan that he's going to put forward before you. And I just want to kind of say that if you thought the meal limit created a major stir in this city, criminalizing homeless this way and privatizing the downtown Bodidley Plaza is going to create a much larger stir. He likes to talk about how he's here to mend divides and do all these things. It's nothing of the such. This is just a further attack on the homeless community here in Gainesville. And again, I would like to draw attention to the connection between this plan and the Collier companies and Nathan Collier, who he works for, and who, when he came to us, he said he represented. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments, Mr. Sinker. Is there anyone else who would like to speak to the City Commission on an item not on our agenda for today?
Good afternoon. I'm Mark Chiskowski. I'm also with the Coalition and the Meal Limit Now. I just want to briefly expand on something that Joe mentioned earlier. I understand that the commissioners would be interested at this point to look into any plan brought forward to deal with issues of homelessness in the city. However, I do want to emphasize that looking into those plans should in no way impact the need to immediately deal with the meal limit. Whatever the commission decides to do to address homelessness in the city, the meal limit right now that it's enforced in St. Francis House does nothing towards that end and needs to be repealed now. Thank you.
Thank you for comments. And could you just restate your last name?
Chiskowski.
Okay, thank you. Is there anyone else who would like to speak to the City Commission on an item not on our agenda for today? Good evening.
Hi, I am Patricia Dunn, actually Patricia Dunn Engel, and I'm a member of the Coalition to End the Meal Limit Now, but I am also a private homeowner. And I think that Mr. Collier is especially out of touch with what regular people have to go through in this city. And I think that he doesn't realize that a lot of the people who are downtown, who he thinks are indigents, are actually the working poor and struggling to feed their families. We have a third of our population lives underneath the poverty level. Our median income in this city is half that of the rest of the state. That is ridiculous. We have a problem with jobs, and we have a problem with people being able to feed their families and take care of themselves. Now, Nathan Collier owns almost 10,000 apartments. So he himself will never be homeless. But a lot of us are one paycheck or one illness away from being homeless. And I think you need to take that into consideration. I think that our city is known, used to be known for our school, and now it is now known for the greed of the school. It is known for our religious intolerance. It is known for how we treat our homeless people. And I think that the decision that you make regarding this will say to Gainesville and the world, you know, Nathan Collier doesn't own me. Nathan Collier doesn't own him. Nathan Collier doesn't own her. And Nathan Collier does not own the city of Gainesville. He owns property here, but he does not own the Gainesville City Commission. And I think that making a decision based on compassion and humanity will show the world that. Thank you.
Thank you for your comments.
Pat Fitzpatrick, I'm a civil indigent center, among other things. Yeah, it is hard to tell. Every building I walk into, they always tell me, the first thing they say is, we have no public restrooms here. I don't know what to do about that, you know. I don't know if you know, hearing Mac McCurchin talk tonight, I mean, somebody got to say, he's, I don't know if you all know, if you've all been around long enough that you're in, he's an amazing person. Amazing person. He's been at this a long time. He's helped more people get their rights and civil rights and other things done than anybody I know of in Gainesville. And I appreciate him being here. And I guess if you were to sum up this 120 thing, for me it'd be like, why do good people do bad things? Because, you know, you all are good people and you're doing bad things here. But lawyer told me to get some things into the record, so I got to say these things. I feel like I am being discriminated against by not being able to feed the hungry. I feel it's my First Amendment right, and I have to get these things stated for the record. And how this comes, I've just picked out three things out of a book of Proverbs. If you oppress poor people, you insult the God who made them, but kindness shown to the poor is an act of worship. Proverbs 21, if you refuse to listen to the cry of the poor, your own cry for help will not be heard. And Proverbs 22, be generous and share your food with the poor, and you'll be blessed for it. And then over here, Then I look again, well, it's at Proverbs. It says, speak up for the people who cannot speak for themselves. This is what you all need to do as commissioners. Speak up for the people that cannot speak for themselves. Protect the rights of those who are helpless. Speak for them and be a righteous judge. Protect the rights of the poor and needy. I think for a lot of people, our main reason for feeding the children and the veterans and the pregnant women is because of our religious experiences. And I feel that this law is denying myself and many other people, not just of a Christian faith, but of all other faiths, the right to feed people. Thank you very much. God bless you all.
Thank you for your comments. Is there anyone else who would like to speak to the City Commission on an item not on our agenda for today? If so, please approach the podium at this time. Okay, seeing none come forward, we will now discuss among the City Commission any items that were brought forward that we feel require a follow-up action. Members of the City Commission, is there anyone that would like to speak to these items at this time? Commissioner Master DeCasa.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And I just wanted to make a brief comment on what Mr. Stockwell had to say. And what this is the first I've heard about his idea or proposals or whatever. But I will say I do appreciate an effort for some dialogue, and I hope that some of our advocates also choose to have some conversation. I think my biggest frustration is there's not people talking with each other, talking at each other. And I still believe there's solutions in the middle ground, but I'm not sure we're headed in that direction. But that is the first I've heard in a while of anybody at least attempting. Now, his what he may have to propose may or may not be viable, but I appreciate the effort and the intention. So I did want to say that. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Master DeCasa. In response to Commissioner Master DeCasa and Commissioner Henry on that particular item, I think another element of any proposal that would come to with respect to modifying this would need to focus on whatever problems that people perceive that there might be actually that actually are actually occurring. That is, that actually if there are some bad actors that are causing overall impact as a result of the activities of the St. Francis House, then they should be held accountable with respect to their ability to participate in the services that St. Francis House provides. And also the clients, frankly, should be impressed upon them, in addition to that, that actually they are ambassadors for the program, and that that actually the should they create negative impacts, that actually that could have ramifications for the program that they're benefiting from and are actually dependent upon. That's something I would see should be a key element in any, say, even a trial run that we may pursue. And that's actually, you know, I think that discussions do need to be had with St. Francis House on that matter, and actually I'll be looking to have a dialogue along those lines with them.